Hey there, Taurus. Welcome to your love reading for the month of October 2019. This month I go live every single day at 4 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. So if you want to catch me live, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell notification icon. These love readings are meant to be quick and they are meant to be straight to the point, and they are meant to provide as much detail as I possibly can about your love life in as little time as possible. So definitely keep that in mind. If you want to know more about this spread that I'm using, it's a spread that I've recently come up with, and I will post a video down below where you can learn more about the spread. But let's get started. So for just overall for love, and this is in the area of new love for you. This is split up into sections, basically, Taurus. It goes new love, the ex, then we have the what you may be missing in love, the unexpected in love, and then the future outcome in love. So for new love, you have the King of Cups. Definitely could be a water sign coming in for you here, Taurus, and water has shown up for you in the daily readings quite a bit. So if you're looking for love, there could be a water sign coming in. This would be someone who makes you feel safe, secure, comfortable, protected. So again, if you're looking for love, it would be somebody who provides those types of feelings. You also have the King of Pentacles showing up here. So it could be like a water sign with earth. It could be an earth sign with water. It could be anything, of course. This is just a general reading, but what I would say is that this could basically be someone very long-term. To me, King of Pentacles is like the true soulmate card. So to me, the King of Pentacles, it's coming up in your solution position for new love. So that would tell me that this could be something long-term. This is something that could be permanent, even if you are looking for new love or if you are finding new love at this time. Your challenge for finding new love is the Hermit. Of course it is for you. This would say that your challenge is needing to get out there, needing to find new love, needing to open up to new love. The Hermit, again, is you being in Hermit mode, pretty straightforward, just needing to open up to new love is what I'm getting here. Your solution is the King of Pentacles. For some of you, I'm getting work. Even with some of these other cards that you have here, if we were to take away all the positions, if we were to take away all the sections, like the meanings of each section, you have a lot of work cards here. So it could be that some of you, maybe you are very shy in love, but this could say that you are maybe finding someone through work. This could also say that for some of you, you could be meeting someone who's like a little bit more bold. So maybe it doesn't matter how shy you are. Maybe they are going to approach you. Maybe they're going to come towards you, and it just doesn't even matter how shy you are, because maybe you're meeting someone who's very bold, brave, and kind of like courageous is what I'm getting. I'm almost getting the King of Wands. So for some of you, it could be a fire sign as well, but just intuitively, the King of Pentacles doesn't represent those things, but I read intuitively anyway. So, again, I don't always use the meaning on the card here. Next, in the area of your ex here, Taurus, you have the Justice card. So this is the overall energy for the ex. And so some of you could be hoping for an apology here, or you could be hoping for the truth. I would definitely say that, because you also have the Ace of Swords coming up in the solution position. So it does look like some of you could be getting an apology. It does look like some of you could be getting the truth. I just did Aries reading, and they had something very similar. It wasn't exactly the same, but I feel like that somebody could be coming in and almost like surprisingly telling you the truth. The Ace of Swords can be a surprise, so I feel like for some of you, this is a like surprise from someone who is interested in you, like a surprise apology or something like that. How they feel about you, your ex here, Taurus, you have the Page of Wands, or you have the Two of Wands. So for some of you, I feel like your ex could want to move towards you. Again, this came up for Aries as well. I find that usually every two signs are very similar to each other as far as the readings are concerned. It's kind of weird, but it's usually how my readings work out. But again, I feel like for some of you that an ex could want to kind of like take the lead here, and they could want to come towards you as well with the Two of Wands. For others, this I just get like the, I feel like saying digging for information. It almost feels like spying to me, Taurus, but it's not, I don't know if it's, I don't really know if it's spying, but you could have like an ex who's asking other people about you, and you could have an ex who's like spying on you or something like that. And it's looking like they're trying to gather information on you. I don't know if this is a good thing or a bad thing. I feel like, it's a general reading. I feel like it'll be different for all of you. And, again, if you want this person back, then I guess it could be a good thing. But I do feel like some of you, this could be the case. For others, I feel like some of you will have an ex who, and again, I don't feel this for all of you, just some of you. I feel like some of you, you will have an ex who will try to come back this month with this card. I feel like they're going to be very bold, and for some of you, I mean, you might be a little bit annoyed here just looking at the rest of the cards, because I feel like they will act like nothing happened. So, definitely something to think about. In your challenge for the ex, we have the Eight of Wands. So just getting communication in the first place could be a challenge. So if you are wanting to hear from your ex, or If you're hoping for communication, it doesn't look like that's going to happen this month, or there could just be challenges coming in. I always tell people, that basically, we have free will and, we can make anything happen that we want. So if you, this is just a challenge. It's something that can be overcome. And we do have a very good solution card as well. So, I wouldn't really worry about it, but hearing communication could be a challenge. The Eight of Wands is also a card of conclusions. So it could say that a challenge for you is wrapping up the relationship or ending it in some way. Your solution is the Ace of Swords. So there could be an apology coming in for some of you. There could be like a shocking revelation as well coming in for some of you as far as love is concerned. But this could also be the truth. Part of me feels like, I feel like saying, you already know the truth here, Taurus. Like, I feel like a very strong intuitive feeling as far as past relationships are concerned. So if you're thinking about an ex, I feel like you know the truth, but I feel like you just want to hear it from the other person. And some of you might want an apology or closure as well. It does look like you could be getting it here with this card. So I feel like for some of you, there could be like a shocking truth coming in from an ex or from somebody from the past here with this card. Next, in the area of what you may be missing in love, you have the Ten of Pentacles. So for what you may be missing in love, the Ten of Pentacles is, to me, the best love card in the deck. Yes, I realize it's a pentacle card. Every time I say it, somebody leaves me a comment about how it's a money card. Yes, I understand that. But to me, intuitively, this is a card of finding your treasure. So in a love reading, to me, it says that you could be missing someone who is your treasure. So if you're focused on an ex, you might be missing out on something that could be so much greater for you. So I feel like you need to focus on finding someone new if you are looking for love. For a small percentage of you, I do feel like you could be hearing from an ex, but you don't have any cards really here of getting back together. Oh, you do have the Wheel of Fortune, so I take that back. To me, the Wheel of Fortune is a card of getting back together with someone, but to me, like I said, for most of you, I feel like new love with this Ten of Pentacles, but very good card of stability and success. I do feel like for some of you as well, there could be love at work and you might just not be seeing it here with the Ten of Pentacles. Next, in the area of what you may be missing as well, you have the Nine of Swords, which could say that you need some time, maybe you need a break. So if you are kind of stuck on someone, or if you're having a hard time in love, maybe you just need to stop thinking about love for a period of time, right? Maybe it's causing too much stress or too much anxiety in your life. So maybe it would be a good time for you to take a break. And so that's kind of what I get here. For others, I call this card the Anchor. To me, the Nine of Swords can represent something from our past holding us back. So to me, it's a card that says it would be a good time to move on to something new. In the area of the unexpected this month, you have the Wheel of Fortune and the Ace of Cups. So someone from the past offering love and truth is what I'm getting here. So I do feel like for some of you, there could be somebody coming back from the past, and I feel like they could be trying to offer you love. For others, this could just be a surprise love offer coming into your life. So I feel like for some of you, there could just be surprise love coming in for you. I feel like it'd make you very happy as well. I'm just getting the word happiness on this Ace of Cups. So if you're looking for love, I feel like in new love as well, I feel like it's surprising, but I feel like it could be very good. I feel like for a lot of you, it could be through work. It keeps popping into my head. So for a lot of you, it does look like there could be opportunities at work for love. Or, it's maybe you are working and maybe someone new starts working where you work, and it could be the new person or something like that. Or maybe you are the new person here, Taurus. For others, I feel that I feel like some of you are on a path. I almost feel like this is saying the next person you meet is going to be a very significant relationship, if not a permanent one. So I definitely feel like the next person you meet could be the most important relationship you've had in a long time. So definitely like to see that. And finally, for your future outcome in love, you have the Moon and the Seven of Pentacles. The Moon to me can represent fears or being taken advantage of in love. So I would be careful of that with the Moon. And the Seven of Pentacles is change in direction in love. So I feel like for a lot of you, even if you go back to an ex, there could be some sort of change in direction where you decide to move on anyway. But at the same time, with all these cards of closure, I always tell people it's me personally, I am very much against going back to an ex in general, but I've always said this on my channel, but recently I've said to myself, people have free will. I don't want to affect that. And on top of that, maybe sometimes it's okay to go back to an ex if you kind of go back to them. Maybe it's that final closure, or maybe you are trying to close out a cycle, if that makes sense. So, I would say don't stop yourself from going back to an ex if you want to here, because I feel like maybe you do break up with this person in the future again, but at the same time, maybe it provides that little bit of cleansing energy that you need is kind of what's popping into my head. For others, this is needing to face your fears. To me, sevens represent internal fears that don't exist. And the moon is definitely a card of fears in love. So I feel like some of you need to face your fears to get the love that you desire. But overall, Taurus, this is very positive. I feel like there could be like shocking truths coming out for you for the most part in love from people around you. But it looks really good. So thank you for watching, Taurus, and enjoy your month.